Constraint relation. Here we will do few examples based on constraint relation. In last section we learned that length of the string is a constraint. That is, length of a string remain constant, and that we use to relate motion of two connected bodies. Beside, we also did work done method, which says that total work done by string is zero because a string does not store any energy. So it takes energy from one body and supplies to others. Let us see here in this example, we have three blocks which are connected with help of massless strings and pulleys. Let's say block A moves to the right having displacement x1. Block B moves right having displacement x2. And block 3 moves left having displacement x3. So the relation between x1, x2, x3 is called constraint relation. We are going to use work total as 0 by the string. Let us see the direction of tension on the two blocks. Since the string is massless, so tension everywhere will be same here, and string knows only to pull objects. Therefore, these will be the direction of tension acting at pulleys or on the block. Work done by these three tensions on the block A will be 3t into minus x1, because tension and displacement of block A are in opposite direction. Work done on the block B will be t, t, t and t, that is 4t into x2. Also, work done by the tension on the third block will be t into x3, because this tension t and x3 are in same direction, and total work done will be 0. Now solving this, we have minus 3x1 plus 4x2 plus x3 equals to 0, which is the required constraint relation. Let us take another example. Here we have two blocks suspended with a pulley, and pulley is accelerated upward with acceleration a1. The block has acceleration a2 and the right block has acceleration a3. We have to find relation between a1, a2, a3, which will be called constraint relation. We will again use work method. The displacements x1, x2, x3 will be proportional to the respective accelerations, that is a1, a2 and a3. So first we will find relation between x1, x2 and x3. The direction of tensions are tension, which is pulling in nature, and for massless string and pulley system, tension in the string remains same and pulling. So the work done by the tension on the pulley will be 2t from the tension on the two sides into minus x1, because the pulley is moving in opposite direction, plus work done by tension on one of the blocks will be t into x2, and on the second block will be t into x3, and total work will be equal to 0. So this results minus 2x1 plus x2 plus x3 equals to 0. But the accelerations were proportionate to displacements, therefore minus 2a1 plus a2 plus a3 will also be 0, and this is the required constraint relation between the respective accelerations. Thank you.